What will I do when you're gone? Who's gonna tell me the truth?
Hey guys.
Who's gonna finish the stories I start where you always do?
So welcome.
When somebody.
It's Thursday, April 2nd. And I thought I would start our opening with a song by Kenny Rogers with the great Dolly Parton. If you didn't catch it, Dolly is now starting a YouTube effort called Good Night with Dolly. She will be reading books to young kids and kids who are young at heart everywhere, including myself. I am planning on tuning in because if there's anyone who can make us feel better, who can really connect to the deep roots of our heart, it is Miss Dolly Parton. So thank you, Dolly. Shout out to her. We have transitioned to the new month of April. So welcome to April. It is going to be a long month for those of us living in Alabama and every part of the country. As we know, we have extended our social distancing, physical distancing, and pretty much staying at home throughout this month and a good chance beyond, but for now, definitely this month. So as we look at April, we are going to look at the idea of fluidity. As we know, it's the old saying, April showers bring May flowers. So how fluid can we be during this springtime, during this time where rain will wash away the pollen for those of us who live in the south, but will clean the air out, will provide a new fresh perspective after each rain, and allow us to recognize that things do change daily and it's important to be as fluid as possible during significant times of change. So as we practice today, we will keep that in mind. We're going to start an extended child's pose. So those of you who might be tuning in for the first time, you will not need two mats. I'm doing this for perspective, so you can see me from the front as well as the side. Sometimes I may even turn to the back, just so you're clear on the position. So extended child's pose, why don't we all come to all fours at first and just move around. It may be the first time today, which wouldn't surprise me if it was, for you to be on all fours. So maybe do cat paws for those of you who like cats. You can also pretend you're like my dog Tucker, who loves to do upward facing dog and stretch forward, and then downward facing puppy, keeping the knees down, hips back. And then maybe shifting forward, elbows soft as he stretches, and maybe curling the toes under, even lifting the hips, lifting the knees slightly and pressing back, and then lowering the knees down, shift your weight forward, extend the hips, activate the glutes. Decide if you want to go ahead and come all the way up to downward facing dog, and then maybe shift forward into plank, and then maybe lower the knees, the chest, the chin. Then reach to the top of the feet, bow the head in, slide the hands back, lift the heart up, deep inhale, settle the shoulders down the back, get the squeeze behind the back heart, find the pinky toe side of the foot, and as you exhale, hips to heel, maybe even gently sway side to side. So you can do any of those variations as you shift toward the front of the mat, as you reach toward the back of the mat, as maybe you float from side to side, maybe you do circles, just moving from all fours, because in a moment we're going to settle in to extended child's pose. Arms pressing forward, reaching out through all 10 fingers, hips sitting back, and then really spreading out through the top of the foot, pressing the feet down into the mat, drawing the low belly up, keeping your elbows lifted as you allow your forehead to rest softly on the mat. So that will be our pose that we'll begin in. I'm gonna let you explore a little more for a few moments if you would like. Just notice what kind of nervous energy you may have brought to your mat today. Notice what movement feels right for you, and it may be settling in to extended child's pose. Now, if you're still moving, go ahead and make your way to that still point. Arms reaching forward, hips reaching back, pressing into the tops of the feet. Begin to expand the breath, taking a deeper inhale, really allowing the back ribs to expand. And as you exhale, draw the low belly in and up. See if you can reach the hips a little further toward the back of your mat. On your next inhale, feel a sense of floating. Rib cage floating off the thighs. And as you exhale, see if you can root back through the base of the spine as you reach forward through the top of the head. Continue expanding the breath and notice how you feel. Notice as you bow your head in and breathe in, you're bringing your attention to your heart space. Notice what is present there in the heart space. What does it mean to be fluid in the present moment? How does that look in your physical body? How does that feel in your heart space? What do you think of in your mind space when you hear the word fluidity? Take one more deep inhale here. As you exhale, walk the hands back, sit back on your heels, reach the arms down, actively lift the heart up. Take an expansive inhale. As you exhale, turn the palms up to the possibility of the breath, the possibility of your ability to be fluid. Take one more expansive inhale, and as you exhale, go ahead and bring your right hand to your heart. Place your left hand on top. Bow your head towards your heart. Stay connected to your empathetic seat. Form your intention around what is present. Where can you be more fluid? Where do you need to be more fluid in your physical body? As you form your intention, bring your hands into Anjali Mudra prayer position. Press your thumbs a little more firmly into the heart space. Bow the head a little deeper, sealing your commitment to yourself. Take an expansive inhale here. And then as you exhale, go ahead and reach the arms up overhead. Turn the palms forward, settle the shoulders down. Draw the low belly back, knit the rib cage, and really breathe. You know you'll notice spots on your shirt as you start. Go ahead and reach that left hand down, really anchor down. Remember, it's like we're swimming through water. We want to find that fluidity of the breath. Turn the right hand toward the left side. Take a deep inhale, and as you exhale, reach up and over to the left. Inhale, come back to the starting point. Exhale, take that reach. One more time, inhale. As you exhale, take the reach. You're going to anchor through that left hand. Give yourself a pat on your left shoulder. Press the back of the head into the forearm. Turn from the back of the head, look to the right. Now shift your hips a little to the right. Breathe into the right side. Maybe soften your left elbow. Can you have a fluid, steady breath? Can you exhale just as smoothly? Take one more deep inhale into that right side. As you exhale, you can use your left fingertips, shift yourself back to center, bring yourself upright, release the arm down. Roll the shoulders up and back. Anchor the arms down, bow the head in. Then take the chin to the right. Slowly take the chin up. Feel as though you're drawing a line across your ceiling as you look to the left and bow back in. Two more times, squeeze between the shoulder blades. Connect to the back part. Draw that smooth line and then come down and around. Last one this direction. Good. Bring your chin down. Gently head bob your head to center. Relax the arms. Good. Go ahead and reach the right fingertips out. Take the left arm up. Good. Take an expansive inhale here. As you exhale, take that side bend. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale, take the side bend. Inhale, come back to center. As you exhale, take the side bend. Look to the right, spread out through the fingers, anchored through that hand. Give yourself that pat on the back. Press the back of the head in the forearm. Look to the left, now shift the hips to the left. Breathe into the left side, receive it. Maybe you'll want to turn your head toward the right. And then look back up to the left, continuing to warm up the neck. Maybe you want to keep the gaze steady and find stillness. Just notice what works for you, and then pause and breathe. Draw that left elbow back, reach that left hip out and down. One more expansive inhale, then as you exhale, shift towards your right hand, bring yourself upright, bring the arm down. Roll the shoulders up and back. Good. Gently head bob. Go ahead and take the arms up. Deep inhale. Turn the palms forward. As you exhale, squeeze the elbows apart. Good. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, elbows apart. Good. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, elbows apart. Pause. Take the elbows back a little bit. Really get that squeeze behind the back part. Press actively into the shins, almost as though you were going to try to stand up. Imagine you're pressing the left hand into an invisible wall. Turn the gaze to the right. Inhale, come through center. Pressing right, turning left. Inhale, center. Exhale, take the turn. Inhale, center. Exhale, turn. Last round, deep inhale. Deep exhale. Deep inhale. Deep exhale. Inhale, center, pause. As you exhale, reach the arms back and down. Turn the thumbs back. That means your palms are turned out. Take the arms back. Take the knees wide. Take a deep inhale. As you exhale, bow in. Try to reach the arms up. On the inhale, sit up. Take the arms up. Turn the palms in. As you exhale, fold in. Turn the palms out. Lower the head down. Inhale, float up. Exhale, bow in and pause. Reach the arms back. If you would like, you can lift the hips up. You can draw the low belly in and up. One more deep inhale. As you exhale, sit the hips back. Turn the palms down. Reach the arms forward. Shift your weight forward. Come to all fours. Wag the tail. So we've done this a little bit before. We're going to stretch the back of the leg. You probably feel the sense of need there, right? Go ahead and take your right foot back. The toes are curled under, mounds of toes are on the ground. You really want to spread out through the toes, have the heel pointing straight up, eyes the elbows turning forward. Inhale, shift your weight forward. As you exhale, reach straight back through the center of your heel. Inhale, shift forward. Drop your heel out, sit back toward the pinky toe side of the foot. Inhale, shift forward, drop the heel in, now reach back toward the big toe side of the foot. Inhale, shift forward, spread out through all five toes. Sit back, pause, look at your right foot. Make sure the toes are spread out. Wrap the hip around, lift the low belly up, traction the heart forward. Now reach your left arm forward, thumb up. Now you can overreach like you're trying to touch the front of the mat and then engage the shoulder. Feel that connection in. Lift the low belly. Barely float your right foot up and pause. Make sure you're breathing. Eye of the right elbow turned forward. One more deep inhale here. And then as you exhale, elbow to knee, forehead to knee underneath you. Inhale, reach it apart. Exhale together. Three more. Deep inhale. Deep exhale. Try to be fluid in the movement. Really float apart. Come together. Float apart. I think this is our fifth one. If not, do one more, but pause. Float on the breath. Float on your effort. Keep your knee where it is. Bring your left hand down. Go ahead and bring your right knee behind your right arm. Warming up our core a little more. Inhale, lower the knee towards your mat. Exhale, lift it right back up. Inhale, lower down. Exhale, lift up. Inhale, lower. Exhale, lift. Two more. Last one. Draw it up, pause. Now reach it back. Now slowly bend the knee, lower it down. Now gently just soften the elbows, sway side to side. Allow the head to be the tail. Get ready for your second side. If you want to go through a brief vinyasa, you can press your hips forward, soften the elbows, lift the heart. Then you curl the toes under and sit the hips toward the heel. Then you can shift your weight forward toward all fours. Lift the hips up, lower the heels down. Your first Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. And you can sway and move here. You can rock forward and back here. You can become a floating quadruped and bend the knees and shift forward and back. You know you're about to softly land your knees, so just decide where you want to be. And when it feels right, lower the knees back down. Take your left foot back. Reach the heel straight up. Dig the toes in. Spread the toes out. Wrap the hip. Lift the low belly. Shift forward towards your hands. Then reach back through the center of the heel. Shift forward towards your hands. Drop the heel out. Now you're reaching back more toward the pinky toe side of the foot. Shift forward. Drop your heel in. Now big toe side of the foot. Shift forward. Spread out through all five toes. Reach straight back through the center of your heel. Look back. Make sure the toes are spread out. Make sure you've wrapped the hip. Lift the low belly. And now traction the heart forward. Good. Now, really press in the mounds of the toes. Feel the upper part of your hamstring, your left glute, and your right low back engaged. And from that engagement, now barely float your left foot up. Now reach your right arm forward, thumb up. Pause and breathe. My life, it's been so good. Where can you express gratitude? Where have you been fluid and you realize that that has allowed you to face adversity? Not attaching to the outcome, but literally going with the flow. One more deep inhale, and as you exhale, elbow to knee, forehead to knee. Inhale apart. Exhale together. Three more. Last two. Last one, pause. Float on your effort. Keep your knee where it is, bring your hand down, take your knee to the back of your left arm. On the inhale, lower it toward the ground. Exhale, lift it right back up. Inhale, lower. Exhale, lift. Three more. Last two. Last one, pause. Good, send it back. Good, lower it down. Soften the elbows. Soften your face. Stay connected to your breath. With soft elbows, shift your hips forward. Take a gentle back bend. Bow your head in, lift the low belly up. Lift the rib cage up. Notice how your glutes engage. Then curl the toes under, hips to heel. Then inhale forward, all fours. Lift the hips up, lower the heels down. Downward facing dog, maybe move a little here. Remember, this is where you can shift forward, you can shift back, you can sway side to side, you can soften the knees and elbows and float forward and back. We're all going to meet in down dog. You decide what movement you want to get there. Now take an expansive inhale into your down dog. As you exhale, walk your hands to your feet so you're forward folding at the back of the mat, soften in the knees. You can bring your fingertips forward, and your fingers are like the little anchors, right? So they're dropping into the mat, the eyes, the elbows shifting forward, toes lifting up. See if you can reach just your big toes down, then press the outer heels apart, and then spread all the toes out and down. And then on the inhale, shift your weight forward towards your hands. Come to the palm of the hand, bend the elbows, lower your head. Then straighten your arms, come up on your fingertips, and then bend your knees, sit your hips back. Inhaling forward toward hands. Exhale, elbows bend. Inhale, straighten arms. Exhale, bend knees. Three more. You should be on your last two. And your last one, bend your knees, sit your hips back and down. Now, take your gaze slightly forward, activate through the foot, really feel like you're pressing the mat away. Notice that'll energize the back of the leg, float the arms up, palms facing down, bow the head in. Really extend the spine, reaching back as you reach forward. Now, feeling anchored through the feet, go ahead and press, float your way up. Good, gaze is forward, arms forward, deep expansive inhale. As you exhale, elbows back and around. Let's do that mindful walk forward, shift towards your right foot. Lift your left knee, maybe move it. Shake out the wrist. Good, then heel toe, shift and lift. Be up to the front of the mat. Walk it out a little. Find the beat. Allow your head to sway. Move the arms, move the legs. And then step into Tadasana. All 10 toes pointing straight ahead. Lift them up, spread them out. Good. Really notice how you can lift that inner arch and activate the foot as though it's floating. It's on that fluidity of the breath, on that fluidity of movement, and spread the toes out and down, a little bounce in the knees. Notice when you do that, you're going to relax your neck and shoulders. Much better than locking out and being stiff. There's no fluidity in locking out the joints. Knees soft, draw the low belly back, reach the arms down actively. Deep inhale, and as you exhale, rotate the palms. Press the ground away. Take the arms out. Don't lock out the knees, though. Turn that left hand out. Find it with your right hand. Bend the knees again. Shift the hips left. Reach up and over. Make sure you're really side bending to the right. Draw your left hip back, left rib cage, left shoulder blade. Turn to the right. Now press the ground away. Breathe into that left side. Maybe turn and look up to the left. Maybe activate the right side and take it a little deeper. Good. One more deep inhale here. As you exhale, come up to center. Bend both knees. Turn that left hand toward the right. Reach it across. The palm is facing down. Bow the head in. Bend the knees a little deeper. Sit back through that left hip as you reach forward through the left arm. Don't lock out. Breathe. Maybe float the left arm up a little higher. Inhale here. As you exhale, release, straight, come around. Urdhva Hastasana, upward facing hands. Take the gaze up, spin the pinkies in. Good, take the gaze forward, draw the arms back. Bring the hands together overhead. Anjali Mudra, take the hands to the back part. So press, really press the hands in the back part. Take the back of the head into the hands. Elbows lifting up. as you reach through the crown of the head. Really anchor back through that entire left side. Just turn from the back of the head to the right. You're not going to go far. Inhale through center. Do the same thing through the right, turning left. Inhale, center. Now you're going to bring your left rib cage, but press your left hip back, turn a little further. So you're counter rotating, come through center, press your right hip back as you turn left. Inhale through center, bend your left knee. Now pose and turn. Deep inhale, come through center, bend your right knee, pose and turn. Through center, inhale into center. As you exhale, extend into center. Go ahead and turn your right hand out. Find it with your left wrist or left hand and bend. Bend your knees. Shift your hips to the right. Do the side bend. Make sure you're really side bending. Keep the right hip back, right rib cage, right shoulder. Good. Turn and look to the left. Now press the ground away. Good. Make sure you're still side bending. Activate the left side. Maybe go a little deeper as you turn to the right. We feel it. Breathe. Stay fluid with your breath. One more deep inhale. As you exhale, go ahead and bring yourself up. Turn the palm out to the left. Reach it across. Bend the knees. Shift the hips back to the right. Bow your head in. Feel as though you're tractioning your arm across as you reach back through your right hip. Breathe. Press the ground away without locking out the knees. Activate through the legs. Maybe float the arm up a little further. Deep inhale. As you exhale, release. Drape the mat. Come up and around. Urdhva Hastasana. Deep inhale here. Turn the palms forward. Elbows back and around. Forward fold. Inhale. A little more than halfway lift. We've been doing that to activate the posterior line. So instead of stopping here, see if you can lift up a little higher. You can even allow the arms to relax because the knees are bent. You're pressing the ground away. You're lifting the low belly up. You're knitting your rib cage in. Pause and receive. Take one more deep inhale. As you exhale, dive in. Bring the hands to the mat. Step your right foot back. Take your left foot back to meet it. Float your hips up and back, downward facing dog. Move a little in down dog and breathe. Maybe moving from hand to hand, bending from knee to knee. Turning the head. You can actually drop your left hip in, turn your right knee to the left, and you can create a little more of a side bend, really activating this right side. Left fingertips can stay on the ground. Or you can shift the hips down, take the arm up, and then press back. You can look up. You can give yourself a pat on the back. All sorts of options here. Deep inhale. As you exhale, left hand down. Shift the hips up and back. Heels reach back and down. Inhale, forward plank. Exhale, lower down. Gentle back bend. Press into the tops of the feet. Lift up. Gaze forward. Bow the chin in. Lift the low belly up. Hips to heel. Second side. Sway. Shift your weight forward. All fours. Soft elbows. Curl the toes under. Move a little. Notice what feels right for you. See if you can maintain a steady breath. Then find your down dog. Go ahead and come up on the tippy toes. Go ahead and drop your right heel in. Turn your left knee toward the right. Activate the left side. So you take your gaze toward your hands. You come up on your right fingertips if you would like and stay here. You can shift the hips down, take the arm up, and then reactivate. Turn and look up. Maybe give yourself that pat on the back. Make sure the eye of the left elbow is turning out to the left. It's almost like you're really tightening the arm into the socket. Good. You bring the hand down. You can take the hips up and back. And inhale, forward plank. Exhale, lower down. Lift the front of the shoulders. Come to the tops of the feet. Lift up. Take the gaze forward. Then bow the head in slightly. Lift the low rib cage, low belly up. Feel your glutes engage. Extend your hips. One more deep inhale. As you exhale, hips to heels, sway. Move. Inhale, round your way forward, all fours. Curl the toes under, float your hips up and back. Expansive inhale. Exhale with a sigh, out the mouth. Two more. On this last one, as you exhale, walk the hands toward the feet. Lower the heels at the back of the mat. Lower the hips, bend the knees. Take the arms up, palms down, bow the head in. Lift the ribcage off the thighs. Draw in and up from the base of the spine, Mula Bandha. Get that root lock, which is like a Kegel or a cable. Feeling anchored through the legs, but floating on the ground. For four, three, two, one, press. Good. Elbows back and around. Good. Shift left, lift right. Shake it out. Good. Remember, heel toeing down and shifting left. Try to move. Be fluid. Find your balance. You can use your arms for balance. Good. Heel toe left. Shift and left. Right foot comes forward. Step your left foot forward. Find Tadasana. Pause and receive. This is where you can rearrange like I'm doing. Good. Reach the arms down. Lift the toes up. Spread the toes out and down. Really create a sense of lift floating on the ground. Arms reach down actively. Deep inhale. As we exhale, rotate the palms. Inhale, arms lift, gaze can lift. Take the gaze forward, settle your shoulders back down, palms forward, arms back. Knit everything in, breathe. Receive your fluid breath. Don't worry if you get off balance, sunlight. We have many safety nets around us. Take an expansive inhale. As you exhale, elbows back around, soft knees, forward fold. Inhale, more than halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Plant the hands in the mat. Your left foot steps back. Right foot steps back to meet it. Hips up and back. Downward facing dog. Breathe. Maybe move a little. Be fluid. You don't have to be stagnant. All right. Activate the pose. Deep inhale. Deep exhale. On your next inhale, shift forward. Exhale, hips up and back. Two more. Last one like this. Hips up and back. Then shift forward, plank, and pause. Eyes of the elbows forward. Soften both knees. Float your hips up. Take your gaze towards your feet. Spread the toes out. And now really sink your heels back. And as you anchor back, now traction the heart forward. Reaching back as you reach forward, lift the low belly up, pause and receive your effort. Soften between the shoulder blades. Deep inhale here, and as you exhale, see if you can lead with the heart lower down. Come to the tops of the feet. Maybe scoot back if you need to, like I am. Rearrange if you need to, like I did. Slide your hands back, draw your elbows back, press into the tops of the feet. Take a deep inhale. As you exhale, bend your left knee. Really squeeze that heel in. The head can rest on the ground if you'd like. Take a deep inhale. As you exhale, re-extend, lift up, turn to the right. Lower back down. Bend your right knee and squeeze. Even think about sliding the top of the knee away from you as you draw the heel toward the glute. Deep inhale. As you exhale, extend. Lift up and turn left. Inhale, lower down, bow the head in. As you exhale, bend both knees. Deep inhale. And as you exhale, extend, lift up, center. Inhale into center. Exhale, hips to heel. Inhale forward, all fours. Curl the toes under, float your hips up and back. Downward facing dog. Go ahead and step your left foot closer to your right. Go ahead and float your right leg up wherever you want it to go. You can move up and down on your left foot. You can bend and extend. Just find the movement that works for you. You can do circles. Be fluid here. We're all going to meet together in a moment. Okay, everyone, lower your right foot close to your left. Turn your right leg in to look at your left. Come up on the tippy toes of the left foot. Now, with your right leg turned in, float it up as you lower your left heel down, saying hello to your left hamstring. Notice your leg won't go as high. Now lower your right leg toward the ground. Rotate the hip open. Now lift the leg even higher. Actively bend the knee. Reach the foot toward the left. Take your gaze toward your foot. Good. Re-extend the leg. Take a deep inhale. And as you exhale, right knee to the right arm. Inhale, shoot it back. Exhale, bring it across left. Inhale, take it back. Exhale, bring it to center, float it up to center. Bow your head towards your knee, float your hips up and back, forehead to knee. Sink your left heel down. Now shift forward and down, bring the knee with you, try to float the foot forward in between the hands. Shake it out, press up, maybe you need to step your back foot a little closer. You can do it. Move front to back, be fluid here. Good. Steady yourself between the two points. So this is where we're really pressing down into our right foot, reaching the inner right thigh forward, really sinking our left knee down. Press your left hip forward. So you're extending, you feel that left glute engage. Breathe. Bring the arms down, turn the palms out, reach the arms up, deep inhale. As you exhale, tilt forward. Now reach back from your left heel, straightening your left. Pause. Make sure your rib cage is off your right thigh. Float on your effort. Anchor your left hand down. Spread out through the fingers. A block can always be under the hand. Reach your right arm forward, thumb up. Reach back for your left heel. Rotate the arm up. Spin the eye of the left elbow forward. And now turn from the back of the head. Look up. Keep that left hip lifted. Breathe. Breathe. Fluid breath. Deep inhale. As you exhale, you bring the right hand down. Press up. Can you reach your left arm back, right arm forward, and drop your heel in? Vira 2. Turn your right palm up. Deep inhale. Exhale. Tip back. Inhale forward. Exhale back. Inhale forward. Exhale back. Pause. Go ahead and bend your right knee a little deeper. Good. Deep inhale as you exhale. A little deeper. Good. Deep inhale as you exhale. Really press the pinky toe side of your back foot. Reach forward through your right knee. And now maybe reach back. Give yourself that pat on the back. Maybe turn forward. Press the back of that left leg into your left hand softly. Wave after wave. Wave after wave of breath. One more deep inhale. As you exhale, reach that right hand forward. We're going to shift forward. So you're going to lift your back heel. You're going to tilt forward. See if you can softly land your right hand. See if you can lift your left leg up, turning the knee out. Going into half moon. Maybe you reach the left arm forward, thumb up. Maybe you take the arm up. Maybe you turn from the back of the head and look out. Maybe you turn from the back of the head and look up. Don't worry if you tap down like I just did. Try to come right back up. Balance challenge. Maybe you look down in anger and you float your right hand up. Wherever you are, deep inhale. As you exhale, left hand down, soft landing of the left foot. You're in a runner's lunge. Step your right foot back to meet your left. Move your block if you have it. Move. Wave after wave. Now, if you would like, you can inhale forward plank. Exhale, lower down. Inhale, lift up, gentle back bend. Exhale, hips to heel, pause and receive your effort. Ride that weight of your breath. Stay fluid and move if you need to. We're gonna go through all of that again. Shift forward, all fours. Eyes of the elbows, turning forward, elbows soft, curl the toes under, float your hips up and back. Downward facing dog. Inhale, forward plank. See if you can drop your elbows back, lead with your heart, lower down. Bow your head in as you lower down. Come to the tops of the feet, slide the hands back. The head can be on the ground or you can keep it floating. Lift your low belly up, bend your right knee. Really draw the heel toward the glute. Take the top of the shoulders away from the ears. Ride the wave, deep inhale. As you exhale, extend, lift up, turn left. Inhale, lower down. As you exhale, bend your left knee, pause, breathe. Maybe slide the top of the knee away from you, lift the low belly up, squeeze the heel in. Deep inhale, as you exhale, extend, lift up, turn to the right. Lower down, bow the head in. Bend both knees, squeeze the heels in, slide the tops of the thighs away from you. Take an expansive inhale. As you exhale, re-extend, find the pinky toe side of the foot, lift up center. Maybe sway center. Hips toward heel. Gently sway. Round your way forward, all fours. Curl the toes under, float your hips up and back. Downward facing dog, move a little. Remember, you're fluid here. And then as it feels right, you're stepping your right foot closer to your left. You're gonna take your left leg wherever you want it to go. Move it the way you want right now. Just notice organically. Notice fluidly what it wants to do. It may do something different than your first side. Now we're gonna steady ourselves. We're gonna lower the left foot right next to the right. We're gonna turn it in so it's looking at the right foot. We're gonna come up on the tippy toes of the right foot. Now with the left leg in internal rotation, float it up. It's not gonna go as high as you lower your right heel toward the ground. Really sinking into that right heel. Good, lower your left leg back down. Rotate the hip open, lift the leg even higher. Now bend the knee. Activate the sole of the foot, maybe take the gaze toward your foot. Re-extend the leg, take the gaze back, deep inhale. As you exhale, knee to back of left arm. Inhale, shoot it back. Exhale, bring it across right arm. Inhale, shoot it back. Exhale, bring it right up into center, float it up to center. Forehead to knee, now round into center. Knee is still to forehead, forehead to knee. Lift the gaze, float the foot forward. Now lift up, rearrange a little, be fluid. Shake it out. It's good to have you guys. Make sure you're breathing. The breath should be fluid. You're not panting, you're not holding your breath. Good, now steady yourself between the two points. So remember, we're reaching the left knee forward, but we're pressing down in the foot too. Notice if you really activate by pressing down, you're gonna feel that hamstring. Now bend your right knee, drop it toward the ground. Now press that hip forward. Now feel like you're trying to drag your left heel towards your right foot. Aha. Extending your right hip, engaging your left hamstring. Take the arms up. Good, tilt forward. As you tilt forward, reach back. Now you're straightening your right leg a little more. Breathe. Good, now go ahead and lower that right hand down. Spread out through the fingers. You're reaching forward as you reach back. Now go ahead and take the arm up. Keep the right hip floating up. Turn from the back of the head. Look out or look up. Squeeze the shoulder blade on the back. Don't drop that right hip. Deep inhale, as you exhale, bring the hand down. Float your way up. Left arm forward, right arm back. Drop your right heel back and down. Make sure your toes are turning more out and your heel is more to the back of the mat. Bend your left knee a little deeper. Turn your collar up. Deep inhale as you exhale, tilt back. Inhale forward. Exhale back. Inhale forward. Exhale back and pause. So this is where you can play with it. Maybe give yourself that pat on the back. Maybe look back and make sure that right foot's comfortable. Maybe bend your left knee a little deeper. Maybe a little deeper. Maybe open up and breathe here.
This world can take it.
You can take it.
Need it around your neck. Somebody you can
good, you can unwind. Remember, you're going to shift. You're going to bring the heel with you and lift. You may have to tap down a little. You'll find your balance, just like I just did. So tap down if needed. Bring the left hand out. You're turning the right hip out. So that knee is looking to the right. You may want to bring the right arm across first and bow the head in. You may want to float the arm up, turn from the back of the head, look out, maybe look up. For balance, maybe look down again, maybe bend your left knee a little, because that is actually a challenge for strength, and maybe see if the hand can float up. Wherever you are, breathe into it, stay fluid. Soft landing, left hand, bring the right hand down, step your right foot back. Yes, take your left foot back, knee to downward facing dog. Move a little to side if you want a vinyasa, shifting your weight forward, lowering down, lifting up, hips to heel. Take the arms up, press up, and imagine that you're squeezing an imaginary beach ball between the legs. Good. See if on the inhale you can lower back down. Exhale, squeeze and lift up. Inhale, lower. Exhale, lift. Three more. Notice in this position, whatever direction your knees are going, that should be the direction of the feet. So in other words, if my knees are collapsing in, my feet need to turn in a little more. If my knees are dropping out, I can turn my feet out a little more. So we're tracking the angle of the knees with the direction of the feet. You probably have already done your last one. So go ahead and squeeze up. Pause. The feet are still turned out. Good. Breathe into center. Receive center. Floating on the breath. Take a deep inhale. As you exhale, bend both knees again. Activate. Press the knees back. Good. Now the hands, you can decide, you can take them out and turn the palms up. You can bring the hands to the waist. You can bring them to the heart space and stay connected to the wellspring of the heart. Take a deep inhale here. As you exhale, we're going to lift our left heel. We're going to drop our knee in. So that's internally rotating. We're going to turn to the right. Then we're going to externally rotate. And then we're going to do the same thing, now dropping your right knee in. Now you're going to externally rotate to the right, internal rotation left, press that left knee back, now turn your right knee in. Now press your right knee out, Now turn your left knee out. Left knee out. Right knee in. Keep your left knee where it is. Right knee out. Pause. Ha, breathe. Bring the hands to the tops of the thighs. Really press the hands in. Lift up. Deep inhale. As you exhale, bend the knees. Drop. Drop that left shoulder in. Really press the hand into the inner thigh. Turn and look to the right. Really press that left thigh bone back. Breathe.
You're the doctors with the medicine.
On the inhale, come up through center, lift up center. Really press right, drop your right shoulder in. Press back and turn and left.
Out of the flame, you need a mirror. Give me a name.
Inhale, come through center. As you exhale, reach both knees out. Good. Bring the palms to the inner knee. Turn the palms out, lift the heart up. Float the arms up. Inhale, turn the palms forward, squeeze the elbows back and around, turn one foot forward, followed by the other. You can toe heel the feet in a little closer, bring the hands behind the back. As you gently clasp behind the back, elbows are soft, draw your shoulder blades together. Sink the hands down without locking out the elbows, so sink, engage, lift the sternum up. Feet are a little bit wider than shoulder width. Soft bend in the knees. Bow the chin in. Reach the top of the head up. Deep inhale. As you exhale, hinge from the hips. Hold. Go ahead and float the hands up. Lift the hips up. Bow the head in. Sway a little. Maybe even bend a little. Steady yourself. Toes pointing straight ahead or slightly turned out. Sit the hips back. Bring the hands to the small of the back. Try to bring the palms together. Lift. Lift the front of the shoulders up. Draw the elbows toward one another. Now reach the arms back. Drop the head in. Take the arms up. Go ahead and bend your left knee. Turn to the right. Deep inhale. As you exhale, bend your right knee. Turn to the left. Moving side to side. Come back to center. Take a deep inhale into center. As you exhale, release the hands down with a sense of purpose. Nice and fluid. Float the hands forward. Walk the hands forward. Step the feet in. Float the hips up and back. Downward facing dog. Breathe. Turn the head from side to side. Receive. Step your left foot closer to your right. Float your right leg up. Rotate the hip open. Lift the leg higher. Bend the knee. And really activate the foot. Spread the toes out. Try not to shift everything to the right. Square your shoulders off. You can turn the hips. Now take the gaze towards your right foot.
It's hard to breathe.
Re-extend the leg. Take the gaze toward the hands. Deep inhale. As you exhale, bend the right knee. Float it up toward the heart. And then see if you can float it forward in between the hands. Move from your right foot to your left foot. Left knee is floating still. It's not down. You may have to step your foot forward. So we're going to do pyramid. So I want you to step your left foot forward. And now both knees are bent. So notice both my knees are bent. I'm going to lift my hips up. I'm lowering my left heel, my back heel down. You want to try to anchor it all the way to the ground. If it's still floating, you can bend again, step it a little further forward, and now see if you can anchor it down. Once it's made contact, hip points, both looking forward, create a smile here by lifting the low belly. Hip points lifting. Reaching back as you reach the heart forward. Press through the big toe, outer heel, fold forward. Fingertips can come down. Hands can come to block. If you have a chair or a sofa in front of you, you can press down and hit and just reach forward. Just notice what works for you. Stay fluid. Don't hike the hip and shift to the right. Try to square the hips off and reach evenly into both legs. Don't lock out the knees. Take one more deep inhale, float up. Shift a little to your right foot. Can you float your left foot back? Come more into a lunge again. Move the block out of the way. So what we're going to do is move from our front foot to our back foot. So you're going to turn to the left. You'll turn your left foot back out to the left. You'll lift your right foot lower down. Then see if you can float forward, lift your back heel, and lower down. Lift up, turn. Good. Shift forward towards your front foot. Now, float back towards your back foot, turning the left foot out back and forward. So we're moving fluidly, floating on our effort. The hands, you can decide. Maybe you want to take a rotation. Maybe you want to anchor all the way down. If you come down, you can take your left arm and really press the outer arm into the inner thigh. Squeeze that shoulder squeezing action. Bhuja Pita. Maybe hand comes the heart. Maybe you float it up. Surfing on the breath. Strength challenge. You can bring the hands together. You can reach the hands forward. Shift a little. Lift. Come back around. Frame your right foot, step it back to meet your left, walk it out. Breathe. We can inhale, forward plank, lower down the way you would like, back bend the way you would like, riding the waves of the breath. We can all meet an extended child's pose, beginning to move toward how we began. Preparing yourself for your second side. Maybe taking true balasana here. Shift your weight forward toward your hands. Drop your knees together. Sit the hips back to the heels. Bow your head in. Bring your arms down by your side. If, as you go in this position, the hips are way up and the head is down, it's a good idea to elevate the head in line with the heart. Also, when you do that, you can gently list from temple to temple, being sure to keep the neck space fluid, allowing the head space to soften. It's also a good time, if you want an inversion, you could go into a headstand here, or any inversion you like before you do the second side. For those of you who don't invert, this is a good time. If there's any movement, any pose that we have not touched on today, this is a good time for you to give yourself permission to be fluid and receive that pose. We'll meet in a moment with the second. Allow the breath to wash over you. Get ready to regroup around our second side. So as it feels right, begin to make your way forward to all fours again. Maybe sway a little. When it feels right, make your way to downward facing dog. Spreading out through the fingers, spreading out through the toes. Stepping your right foot a little closer to your left as you float that left leg up and rotate the hip open, lifting the leg even higher. Notice if you shift toward the left, keep your shoulders level. Make sure it's your hips turning, and then you can reach the foot toward the right. You can take your gaze toward the right, either over your shoulder, underneath the side. Breathe. Re-extend the leg, take the gaze toward the hands. Deep inhale, and as you exhale, float that knee up into you, lift it up. Maybe round in a little, maybe shift forward and down if you want a little more strength. And then float the foot forward. Stay nice and low. Notice that back knee is soft. Relax. Remember, we're going to step the right foot forward enough that we can lower both knees down so we're crouching, right? We're steady. Steady on the breath. And then you can lift up and maybe lower the back heel down. As you lower the back heel down, you can keep both knees soft. Make sure the hip points are smiling. The low belly is lifting. Notice if you shift too far to the left, really find effort through both legs. See if you can extend forward and down. The block can be helpful. You can take it out long in front of you. You can even spread out through the hands. Press the palms down, lower the head down, activate the legs, square the hips off. You can also have something that's the height of a chair or a sofa and press into that, reaching forward as you reach back. Soften the left knee, shift a little left. Can you float your right foot up and just step it back? Nice lunge. Now we're working from the inside of our left foot, walking around, maybe bringing our arms with us. Turn your right foot out, lift the top of your left foot, and then moving back toward the front of the mat, then flowing to the back of the mat. Notice how you want to move. Do some cross lateral work, reaching that right hand across, turning back. Maybe you want to bring your right hand down and do a little bit of a rotation. Maybe you want to drop into your back foot. Find the arm in the inner thigh. Maybe bring the hand to the heart. Maybe float. Ready to get up. A little bit of effort. You can bring the hands together energetically. You can lace the fingers. Shift, press, and lift. Come around. Lower down. Take your left foot back. Walk it out. Notice any final poses, stretches you might need here. Maybe you want to do a nice gentle vinyasa. Inhaling forward. Exhaling slowly down. Maybe allow the head to be the tail. Lift the low belly up. Maybe take the arms back, palms down. Lift the front of the shoulders up. Lift up. Maybe take the hands up, feet up, breathe. Maybe bring the feet back down. Bend at the elbow. Hands slide back toward the feet. Lift up, deep inhale, hips to heel, exhale. Shift your weight forward toward your hands, drop your knees in, true balasana, hips drop back, head bows in, arms come down by the side. Maybe you gently list. Stay where you are. Recall your intention. Breathe into it for a few moments. Notice how you feel. Come into stillness, and as you breathe, notice where the breath moves fluidly in your body. Notice any places in the body that feel as though there's a dam built up. Can you move your breath into those spaces? Can you allow things to flow? Not attaching too much to the present moment. Take one more expansive inhale. As you exhale, press down into the shins. Bring your torso up. If you can, without using your hands, drop your hips off to one side or the other. Extend your legs out long, preparing yourself for Shavasana. As you do that, you can walk from heel to heel, from cheek to cheek. You can roll your legs in and out. You can knead from side to side. And then you can anchor forward, spreading out through the toes, lifting the heart. Maybe bring that left hand to the heart, right hand to the low belly. Thank you.
recall your intention and bow your head toward your heart. Lift your heart toward your head and receive your intention. Bow your head just a little deeper in gratitude, and I want to thank you for joining me again today. I hope you have a wonderful weekend. Stay really fluid in your breath, fluid in your movement, and open in your mind space. Thanks again, and namaste. Remember, you may want to take a few moments to do any final stretches and really move into Shavasana, your final resting pose, a reclined position of your choice.